Hi, how are you?
Hi.
After so long. Hi, how are you? You're getting fried.
Yeah, it's yeah. like
finding happiness under the sun directly.
Itni garmi.
Hi, garmi.
Okay,
so I'll quickly ask you a couple of questions and you need to answer them right through from your heart. And the first question is, what are your three favorite words to describe yourself?
Real, honest, and happiness.
I think we totally relate these
yeah,
words.
Yeah, because we will understand that this is these are the three words you would have chosen. But yeah.
If I had a name, it would have been Sukhi.
Oh, Sukhi. Yeah. Nice.
Oh, I love that name. It could be an alter name.
Yeah.
Lovely. And I think I will also say witty is another word for you. I think
witty.
That is what suits you too. What do you think?
What is the dictionary meaning of witty?
Oh God.
Witty is
just like coming up with something super fast and making
and
people
also,
laugh.
Yeah, and also humor.
Yeah.
I think that
humor?
Is a lot in you.
Okay.
Yeah.
Good. Okay. Nice.
Cool.
Somewhat as that serious of people think about like all my words and like, you know, words coming out and all that stuff doesn't happen.
No, I don't think
so. I think that's another angle
see, God
angle
heard
that you.
You
have.
The next one is, what's one overrated and underrated life advice according to you?
Overrated, underrated. Underrated is that, you know, happiness comes from within and you need to live every moment. I think it's a very, I know everyone talks about it, but it's still a very underrated statement.
Yeah.
It's because every time we say that, let's be happy from within, we go exactly do the opposite and then we say, oh my God, you know.
Yeah. We blame
the
circumstances.
Taught us everything that we need to live each day as it comes and just be happy with it.
Yeah.
And I think that's the most underrated statement, that happiness within, happiness every day, live each day with happiness and do your own little things of joy.
Yeah,
these are words which we really need to follow.
Yeah, it's a lovely thing.
I know, we keep reading it and hearing it constantly, but
sometimes
we don't
forget.
Do it.
Yeah, we forget.
Yeah.
And it's underrated because people think that money can buy me this. I can do this and get happiness, but yeah.
But you have to make it a lifestyle, you know, that finding happiness from within. And what I do is I wake up every morning and I tell to myself that, you know, I'll make sure that I'm really happy throughout the day and do something for someone that also makes the other person happy, that brings me happiness. And otherwise, you just
overrated.
Forget.
Overrated. I don't know. I do believe a lot that what you put out in the universe really comes back to you in some way or the other. You also have to work towards that. So yes, I do believe that it's very important to work towards something, have it in your mind and truly believe that it should happen. But just by saying that, you know, put it out in the universe and the universe will conspire to give it to you is never going to happen.
It totally is. I love the dialogue.
I feel that it's important that, yes, you need to put it in the universe. There is a whole universe out there who's listening to you, who's guiding you, who's making sure that you, and conspiring to make sure you do what you believe in and what you have in your heart. But it is as simple as that. I always want to lose weight, but I can't keep telling the universe that, you know, I want to lose weight. And and you know, things will happen.
The truth is that you have to
at least work towards it.
Work out or eat well.
Do something. And then the universe will say, hey, you know what? You are doing that. So now I'll go down there with you.
Yeah, you can't just get lucky and get everything.
So I do feel that it is very important. So this line,
it's a good one.
Has a deeper meaning to it.
Yeah, it does, yeah. It's a good one. I never thought of it from that angle, It's overrated. If you could go back and relive one incident from your childhood, what would it be?
Oh, wow. If I have to relive one childhood incident, then I think it would be just not really worried about anything, and getting up really late in the morning, like, and no one to tell me that, you know, it's like 11 o'clock and 12 o'clock in the afternoon and you cannot like sleep so long.
Yeah.
And when I see kids sleeping, when I see babies sleeping, there's so much of joy is because we crave for that. Like, I crave for the fact that what if one day I could just like sleep at like 10 o'clock,
but you know, there is a,
and not see the phone, yeah, and even in the morning not see the phone. And
but that's the other way around. The kids will think, Ma can do so many things now that she's telling me not to do it. I think elder people have that liberty to do it, and they don't want to do it. They would want to grow up.
Yeah, but how many of us, and please put this in your comments, how many of us really want to have like a good night sleep?
Yeah. Ask me about that.
Like a sleep where you switch off the phone.
Not get
about
bothered.
About 10:30, you like this, like completely
switch
make
off.
Your room as comfortable
sleep
as possible.
Worthy.
And just sleep with your Rajai. And and see, they are laughing. Because they all wish. We all want that. And then get up without being disturbed.
Yeah.
By a call or somebody. By a call, by the doorbell.
Yeah.
By anyone who is saying, you know, get up, it's late. Or we
have to do
okay,
something.
Forget everything else. We are still feeling guilty that, oh, why have we woken up so late?
Yeah, the guilt is actually
the most important thing. Yeah. So,
And
the sweat
I want
is
to
killing
go back
us.
To...
Yeah, I think we... should we just cut here?
No, I want to say something, another one thing. Yeah. I just remember that day from childhood where I don't have to wear a bra and worry about what is going where and just run around naked on the beach. That feeling of freedom.
We're talking about childhood, yeah.
Yeah, it's so amazing, you know.
I think that's what holiday is, you know. Holiday lets you do that.
And nowadays, you just can't think of doing that. And I have to be a kid to get back to doing that, of course. But I want to get back. What was it that sparked the inspiration in you to write a book?
I think all of us are creative in some way, like both of y'all. Y'all are all left-brainers, have like really studied well and have great jobs. But there is this creative instinct which is there in you, and that made you establish Sutta.
Yeah.
And in the way you have been evolving and you have been learning so much about yourself, about the various aspects of just not building Sutta the way it is, but also what can happen around Sutta. Like, we both of all three of us talking here is that.
Yeah, it is.
So for me, I think it was an extension that I had done my commercial arts from Sofia Polytechnic, got into advertising, was an art director, then became a creative director, then became an executive creative director, handled clients, managed from the business side, you know, and then I got into films. And but there is always a side which is a side of storytelling, and storytelling in any form is just a tag which is given to various kinds of people. So you are storytellers in form of what
different
you do
kind,
I'm a storyteller in form of different medium. So for me, the book was something which I wanted to sit and write, and I also felt that, you know, how it would be like if I was somewhere, you know, the whole idea of writing a book in
it's
solitude
beautiful.
The whole idea of no deadlines and just sitting and writing, it's a process, is because you have to be super disciplined, and you need to like every day make sure that you're writing at least a few pages. And that's the common most thing. I do feel that we all have a storyteller in us in some form, whether you have forgotten to dance, or whether you are a good singer, or whether you are good in embroidery, or whether for men and women.
Yeah.
I do feel that it's very important to revive the storyteller in you. But you have to just be disciplined in that, is because you cannot be, again, it's like, you know, you want to do it, but then you have to make sure you
Everything is a process.
It's a process.
Yeah.
So for me, writing was a whole process of getting back to myself, where I could sit in any corner and write in the most beautiful places and my own self. And I think that's a very beautiful feeling, is because it's also, see, there's a difference between solitude and loneliness.
Yeah.
solitude is enjoying the time with yourself and doing things for yourself. So that is what for me is. Writing a book was the most amazing form of solitude. It was the most, it was a kind of chapter in my life right now where I would like the audience and the readers, I always tell audiences because for me it is cinema, I would like my readers to take the story in their own world. Because so if there are 1,000 readers, every reader will have his
own version,
his or own different interpretation.
Yeah.
And that's what
that's the most
every
beautiful
form
part
of storytelling is.
Yeah.
So when I'm wearing this sari today, for me, I'm feeling very different versus what you would be feeling, what it would be. So,
it is, yeah.
So yeah, it's good to explore different forms. I think you should be singing more, and I kind of see the kind of writing that you do. No, that's another form of storytelling. Every post you put, write something.
Yeah.
And that you talk about that sari, you metaphorically speak about it. And I think that's the reason why we are doing
today. I think we connected also because of that, right? I think
yes.
We connected because of that, right?
Yeah,
the
I think
kind
that's
of people
the reason
we are
doing something about mapping love. And
yeah.
So sweetly, they have done this little embroidery. I do not know how much it can be visible, but thank you so much for this. And this whole thing, there are a lot of people.
It's talking
and
about
stories
love.
About
they're all carrying their hearts out.
Yeah, and the story, every story is about human connection. So
yeah.
Here there is a human connection in the sari. Applique work from Orissa.
Yeah, from Orissa.
Yes, yes, yes. So beautiful.
We should all learn how to, you know, be in solitude and love yourself. And, you know, a lot of people don't know what to do when they're lonely. And not lonely, when they're alone. And learning.
See, there's a lot of difference between lonely and alone.
Big
yeah.
difference. And then learning to love yourself and being on your own and doing something is something which we all should learn.
And also, storytelling need not always be beautiful and always. You,
yeah.
It can be just a story.
Any
according
story.
To you, could be beautiful, not beautiful.
Yeah.
I think writing it itself
it's
is a process.
Story.
Yeah,
yeah
it
it's a beautiful process. I think the process is more important than what outcome it is. I think that's what is important. I started writing a book long back, which I never finished. I didn't do anything about it.
I think yeah, but I think now it's time that you should do it, and you can very easily.
You've inspired me. So yeah.
I think I am not a person who can write, but I love reading. I absolutely love reading. So Mapping Love is my next for sure. And
yeah, please.
And then I'm just eager to read it. Very eager.
Yay!
What is your favorite day of the week?
I think it should be weekends. But for me especially, I don't think so there is any something called a weekday and a weekend.
Mm-hmm.
And especially after the pandemic, the treacherous pandemic, where we all have been, you know, inside our homes, every day seems to be. Some days there are like lots of meetings, or some days there's nothing.
Mm-hmm.
But it's also kind of very it's very different in terms of the timelines, is because there is a little less importance to your time here right now.
Yeah.
But if you ask me what's the best time of my day, I think it should be in the morning. But I cannot get up in the morning as much as I want to. I think that's the best time.
I agree with
before
you.
Before dawn should be the
yeah.
best time, because it's the most calmest time where the whole world is sleeping.
Again, staying
sleep.
With yourself then.
Yeah. So I feel that then the next best day should be in the evening, right? I'm a nocturnal person. I love... in a sense, a nocturnal... I love to go for my walks in the night.
Even I love
or early
walks.
Morning.
So I love any
sunrises.
Kind of walks, but I love mornings the best. But I don't get up. That
yeah,
early.
Yeah.
Yeah,
I think I like...
For you now, I think it's day and night.
Anytime.
Anytime.
Some
what do I like? When I get to sleep.
So,
great, yeah. It was awesome.
Thank you.
Doing this chat with you.
And
it was long
if
pending.
If we need more, then we can do more. That's
yeah.
fine. Yeah,
yeah. There are a lot more questions that we have in store for Ashwini. And
we'll
lot
take
more
this
chit-chat.
Take this live later
yes.
on Insta.
Yeah, I think we should do
it,
that.
It will be good.
Yay.
Let's
yeah.
do that.
And just to do a little talking about Mapping Love, it's releasing on August 1st. And please go on to Amazon and pre-order it or book it or do whatever.
You guys are going to love it.
That
I've
was
just
a little promotion from my side.
Yeah.